Introductions will continue, but for the purpose of the players, we're going to allow you to get back on the field and continue your warm-up to stay warm. The officials for the game are, starting with the referee, les officiels pour le match, en commençant avec l'arbitre, Dustin Ceretti from the Toronto and District Rugby Referees Society, and touch judges, Karen Lozada and Andrew Hosey, who are also both from the Toronto and District Rugby Referees Society.
Test.
The Gaels will be wearing gold jerseys and will be designated as the home team on the scoreboard. The Stingers will be wearing maroon jerseys and will be designated as the visiting team on the
test.
The coaches from Queen University are Aonten Alpha leading up to Queen's Saw, head coach Beth Barnes, and assistant coaches Sean Dunleavy and Vicky Ward. The players for the Gaels are Les joueurs pour les Gaels Saw, Taylor White,
this is muted.
Amanda
that's
Durkovich, Clara Pegg,
this is number
Michelle
two.
Krenenberg, Melina Weiss, Kayla Roots,
this is two.
Jocelyn Poirier, All Canadian team
that's
Ash Ward. Girolamo Gulli and Mel Waring. The players for the Stingers are Les joueurs pour les Stingers sont Mandy Aldridge, Anastasia Assimakopoulos, Jessica Baudry, Adara Boris, Solange Dubois, Melissa Gagnon.
Test.
Both teams have prepared for the opening kickoff.
Good morning and welcome to day two coverage of the CIS Women's Rugby National Championships from Trent's Justin Chiu Stadium. I'm Sandy Kay, with me is Ed Holton. We'll be broadcasting live over the streaming sports network for you today. As you can see by your screen, the snow has started to fly, making conditions very difficult, Ed, for both teams.
Well, very exciting. Number five, Queens, against number four, Concordia. And the kickoff didn't go 10. As you know, Queens lost the breaker yesterday in the first game in overtime to top-ranked defending champion Lethbridge. So we'll see how Queens rebounds today, Sandy.
They've got to be pleased with their efforts yesterday against number one seed, pushing them right to overtime. I don't know if that extra game is going to be a benefit for them. They've certainly settled into the tournament, but it was a physical game yesterday and maybe a bit of wear and tear.
Well, we have talked about that. Three games over 4 days for these teams. We're seeing the slippery ball already.
We are we're underway. Scoreless tie, just less than a minute underway. Queens will be wearing the gold jerseys on the left side of your screen. Concordia wearing maroon and black on the right side.
What a great day we had yesterday, Sandy. We were discussing the unbelievable crowds we had out yesterday for the Trent game yesterday afternoon. Actually, for both games, well attended, but the home crowd came out to support Trent.
Today we've got the diehards under their umbrellas for this one.
I've seen fans representing both schools braving the weather. Here, Concordia on a quick tap and end up knocking it on.
Expect there'll be lots of mistakes in these difficult conditions. Queens in possession. Ball moved smartly to the wing. But Karen Lozada, the touch judge, signals ball is out of play. Lineout coming to Concordia.
Good run by Queens. We talked about that yesterday, the Queens forwards joining the back line and doing some good things.
Concordia's Adara Boris to put in. Well taken by Concordia off the top. Concordia's 10. Erica Hamilton does what she can to keep the ball alive. Well picked by Concordia. And they're in possession. Ball comes free. Number one, Taylor White from Bancroft, Ontario, keeps possession for Queens, and the ball's out. Kick finds space on the far side of the field. Concordia's winger, I believe that's Mandy Aldridge on the far side. No, I believe that's, pardon me, that number 11, Patricia LaPierre on the far side, fields it well.
And well up by Queens.
Good for them. They're going to hopefully take use of the field position. They've got Concordia in their own end, just inside their 22. Let's see what Concordia can do now to defend their own end. Maul is formed and Maul is driving. Good job by Queens. Ball out by scrum half Susan Held. 10 keeps it. That's Annika Rinnis. She had a great game yesterday. Good line formed of Concordia Stinger defense.
And they've stolen.
You can hear this smaller but appreciative crowd enjoying the snow, enjoying high caliber rugby. If you're just joining us, we are just about 5 minutes into the first half. Score is tied at zero here on the first game of day two. The CIS National Championships.
Well, it'll be interesting to see how these two teams match up. You've got the Quebec champion, the OUAA runner-up. And we certainly know Queens is a capable team based on their result yesterday with Lethbridge.
Absolutely right. And Concordia did not have an easy time getting through their Quebec division. Very, very close games all the way through. Some very tight games with Laval.
I'm sure they're happy to be the Quebec champs and to be here today.
I believe this is their, is it fifth appearance?
Fifth appearance by Concordia.
It's a very very well coached team. In fact, Coach Graham McGravy was just recently honored with the CIS Coach of the Year for this year at the awards banquet Wednesday night held here on the Trent University campus.
And how about Queens with their first appearance at the CIS Women's Rugby Championship? And as I mentioned, a great, great first effort in their game yesterday.
Absolutely right. And they're certainly well represented on the national stage. They're eight. Ashley Ward in gold, just to the back of the scrum there, is a CIS All-Canadian. That kick doesn't find touch. Fielded by Queens. That's fullback Sam Trinier with a good run up the middle. Second phase coming. Ball it well to Andrea Wadsworth. MVP of yesterday's game. Here's Jocelyn Poirier.
Oh, I think she...
Bit of a miskick there, Ed. But
yeah, but it worked out all right.
That still may work for them. No, that's Concordia in possession now.
Oh, like you said, Sandy, Poirier with a great game yesterday. She's an excellent runner, an exciting rugby player.
I liked the game plan with her. having her as that intermediary between the backs and the forwards. She's often the first person to get that ball. Coaches are Beth Barrs using her speed and getting an overlap, getting extra numbers out there in the backs, and they certainly used that yesterday against Lethbridge. Ball won by Queens in the lineout to Carly Wong. Carly Wong breaks a couple of tackles and into contact. Queens inside Concordia's 22.
They're getting close.
There's All-Canadian Ashley Ward with a run.
I think they've turned it over.
Referee signals a knock-on. Referee Dustin Ceretti, this is the first game that we've seen him calling the shots in this tournament. Very highly regarded referee.
Just like the playing, the refereeing has been excellent as well.
Certainly you'd expect no less at the national championships. And they've done a great job yesterday, and it appears that the same is happening for us today.
So we're 8 minutes in and still scoreless.
Concordia to put in.
And Queens is stolen.
Loose ball. Picked up by Concordia. Very near their goal line.
A little bit messy, but to no fault of the players.
Loose ball. It's hard to see who's got it now. Concordia forms a solid ruck there. And well kicked. I believe that was Jackie Titley, but she doesn't find touch. That's Queen Sarah Pathick on the far wing, taking the ball into contact. Queen's attacking again. We saw this yesterday, Ed. They dominated possession, even though an tough overtime loss against Lethbridge. They certainly had the bulk of the ball. Referee signals a penalty against the Concordia Stingers. I think a little bit too far for a penalty try at the posts. A difficult place to find touch from the middle of the field. They may be happy just to run this one.
I think you're right, Sandy.
Susan Held organizes.
Now in comes Renas to kick. Just making sure.
Well done to find touch. We'll have a Queens line out. Just about 10 minutes in, scoreless tie from Justin Chiu Stadium at Trent University. This is game number 3. The Concordia Stingers on your right wearing maroon, Queens in gold.
Well, I guess you'd call this a must-win, Sandy, with Queens unfortunately losing that tough one yesterday.
It really is, Ed. If they have a hope to play for gold, there's got to be a win here after a tough loss, as we said yesterday, to the Lethbridge Pronghorns.
And then Concordia tomorrow morning will play the winner of that game, the Queens-Lethbridge game. They'll play Lethbridge at 11 a.m. tomorrow.
And certainly a win for Concordia will do much for their spirits. And put them in good position to battle for a medal. Ball won by scrum half Jesse Lapointe for Concordia. Ball recycled. Forwards make a nice charge. Into contact. Queens organizing on defense. Phase 3. Well done by number 7, Huanna Gaw. There's that slippery ball. A referee letting that one play on, apparently. He's either generous or perhaps missed that. Ball available for Concordia.
Some good work here by Concordia.
Another knock on. The referee's got that one. Scrum coming to Queen's University.
So we're playing 35-minute halves, and we are about 12 minutes in and still scoreless, Andy.
I suppose you can expect that on a day like today where conditions are difficult, it's certainly going to be the team, I think, that makes the fewest mistakes may come out with a win today. But you're going to expect mistakes from both teams. It's not just the snow if you're watching this. Temperatures hovering just above the freezing mark. Very difficult conditions for both teams compared to what we had yesterday. Pass back inside to 8 Ashley Ward. Queen striking now inside the 22. Well done by Poirier.
Oh, here's a chance for Queens. Going to take it quickly.
They're not going to... They have an option to kick at the posts here, and they're just maybe deciding what they're going to do here. They're certainly within range. Looking to coach Beth Bars, maybe, and yes, they have decided to go for posts.
Looked like they were going to go quickly, and probably a good decision in this weather.
I agree with you, Ed.
Take the points when you have a chance, especially when the weather could get worse before it gets better.
That's right. And first points, I think, are critical in these matches, both for confidence and certainly for their for the opposition to be down 3 all of a sudden. It may force them to try and do a little bit more and maybe make mistakes.
I believe yesterday Queen scored the first try on Lethbridge.
They did. Lethbridge is doing a good job to come back in that one.
And it's through.
Rinnisk converts 3 points for the Queens Golden Gaels. They take a 3-0 lead.
Penalty goal made by Penalite. PUC foul, number 10, Annika Rinnisk.
13 and a half minutes in, and Queens has the first points of the game. 3-0 to Queens over Concordia.
Concordia to return the ball.
It's a nice kick.
Get this just well done it, just getting that ball 10 meters. It's got to go to that dashed line. Well by Concordia. It's Danny Maidney, the winger for Queens. I believe that's possession. Held has it for Queens. There's Poirier in our usual spot off the just off the loose ball. Oh, misplayed by Carly Wong. Referee will call a whistle.
Tough luck. Some good series by Queens. These teams look very well matched, and as the score indicates early, about 15 minutes in, 3-0 for Queens on the single penalty kick. Here comes Queens on Concordia on a bit of an attack, but it's turned over.
Intercepted by Maidney from Queens. Possession so important here. Ball out to Rinnis. Who's got the 3 points for Queens thus far. Taken by Sarah Pathak, winger for Queens University. Queens inside their 22, but moving the ball well. Good phases, utilizing both forwards and backs. Fullback Sam Trinier. Fortunately lost that ball forward in contact. Scrum coming to Concordia.
Well, it's a tough go. You have possession, but it's hard to make a lot of passes in a row without knocking it on with the slippery ball. The Queens is doing a good job so far.
I think both teams are warmed up now, and hopefully settling in. We've seen a lot of drops, a lot of knock-ons thus far. Hopefully, teams find their rhythm and can play like they can. Certainly as a forward player, it was nice seeing conditions like this. You knew that maybe they were going to get more ball kept in the forwards rather than chasing backs across the field.
Exactly.
Scrum to Queens.
I also find the bad weather tends to be a good even outer, if you know what I mean.
Absolutely. Don't think it favors one team or the other. Today, this is our first look at Concordia. They seem to match up well in the scrum, their forward pack. Apparently of equal size. Referee doesn't like that one collapsing. They'll redo that scrum.
So we're halfway through the first half. 3-0 Queens at this point.
I'm sure Queens would be happy just to keep it between the 22s for the rest of this game with a 3-0 lead.
Snow's picked up, Sandy.
If it's the first time you've seen the Trent University field, it is the artificial turf. Big run by Ashley Ward. We are starting to see that snow accumulate on the field, but it certainly does drain. We had rain last night, but it certainly was drying out very nicely this morning. Conditions on that field about as good as they can be. Referee signaling advantage to Concordia. Second phase coming. Another drop, but who? Referee says advantage wasn't gained. So that penalty will occur.
Well, I think you're right, Sandy. It'd be a different game if it was being played on real grass. This field really drains the waterway nicely.
Certainly would be muddy. Kick from fly half. Erica Hamilton finds touch just about the Queen's 22. About 16 minutes remaining in the first half. Concordia not really getting into the flow of their offense. They've managed to put a couple of phases together, but knocked balls have unfortunately slowed them down. Ball in one smartly by Claire Hortop, and Concordia is driving, and driving well.
Good drive. They're getting close here, and they're still going.
Poye has to join on. More Queens forwards have to join. That's what you'd like to see. And penalty called. Great position for Concordia.
See what they do here.
I didn't get a look at what was called there by the referee, Dustin Ceretti.
And a little kick to touch. And they will take the 5-meter line out and see if they can punch it over.
Great position for Concordia. These are the opportunities that they have to make the most of in close games like this. Claire Hortop's done a great job jumping in the line. And she takes it again.
And again, nice. And see if they get the drive on.
Queen's not doing much to challenge in those lineouts.
Over the try line, but not touchdown.
Referee indicates that ball was held up. Contact not made between ball and ground. So it'll be a 5-meter scrum to the Concordia Stingers.
Now keep in mind, this Concordia team came in 8-0 overall, 6-0 during the regular season, and 2 wins in the playoffs. So they've yet to see defeat this year.
That's right, then. I don't think they're looking forward to it.
And
I was going to say, yeah, they've done a good job in those close games. Good teams find ways to win these tight games.
Oh, we were talking about that before the game started. The 3 games against Laval, they won 10-9, 15-10, and 13-8. So 11 points difference in 3 games. So I'm sure Laval wishes they could be here, think they could probably deserve to be here, but Concordia at 8-0 is the Quebec representative. So we have a player down.
Yeah, time being called on the field. Looks like number 15, Sam Trinier, being looked at.
Well, the trainer tends to the injury. If we can guide our attention to the north side of the field, actually the Concordia, and just to take a note of our sponsors, as many sponsors who have made this event possible.
Stadium announcer Ash Walker mentioning the numerous sponsorships that were gathered to make this event a possibility for Peterborough and for Trent University. That's something you know a fair bit about, being on the committee.
Mm-hmm. We had an excellent committee. Bill Byrick and his gang have done a great job, and I know they're looking forward to hosting again next year.
A two-year commitment for Trent.
13 minutes to go in the half, 3-0 Queens, but Concordia with a chance to take the lead. A 5-meter scrum.
Driven well by Concordia, that's an 8-pick. Kara Stuckey.
And she's over.
Converts, well done.
Nice set play there. And Concordia takes the lead, 5-3. A lot of fans made the trip from Concordia, you can hear them. Quite pleased with that.
A lot of maroon and gold underneath us.
Be a very tough convert here, though.
We'll be given that angle in these conditions. But the lead nonetheless for Concordia, 5-3. We talked about Trent hosting again next year. We saw them in action yesterday, and certainly coming in with an 0-4-1 record. That wasn't the kind of season that they wanted to have. But nonetheless, they've got great coaching and great personnel on the field. They'll certainly work hard to...
Oh, and she got it. She got the convert from that distance and that angle.
Very well done. I believe that was Jackie Titley doing the kicking for Concordia.
And it's 7-3 Concordia. That'll be a real lift for Concordia.
Certainly will. I suppose it's easy to see now why Titley led the Quebec Conference in scoring with a kick like that.
And as you mentioned, a 2010 CIS All-Star. That was a great kick.
Concordia set to receive.
Well, you were mentioning the Trent game.
Kara Stuckey. Essay réussi par numéro 8, Kara Stuckey. And convert made by number 12, transformation réussi par Jackie Titley.
I think it was agreed that Trent put up a good fight, and some of the scores that St. FX has put up against other opponents, Trent didn't do too badly.
I absolutely agree. Speaking with coaches Nancy Marcotte and Craig Harris after the game, they simply said they played well. It was 6 missed tackles they counted that really, really sealed their fate. But very well played. The players were pleased with their performance and looking forward to the Guelph game today. Penalty going against Queens. An obstruction call.
10 minutes left in the half. Concordia now in the lead, 7-3 on that converted try. Nice kick by Concordia, finds touch, bounces in and then out. And the line-out's down the field. The try has roused the Concordia supporters.
This is the first time we've seen separate kicking duties. That's Erica Hamilton doing the kicking for touch, where Jackie Titley does the conversions for goal.
Right. And tried a short line out there. Concordia's going to pick and go and try to get some field position. And another knock on.
Another Concordia knock on. I empathize with players playing in these conditions. The hands start to freeze up. Ball becomes harder. Just difficult to control. See players rubbing their hands together, hands in the armpits, anything that they can do to try and keep warm. Ball in from Queen's scrum half. Susan Helen, she...
Good drive by Concordia.
Controls her forwards.
And the steal.
Concordia in possession. Loose ball cleaned up nicely. And Concordia attack off the rack. Ball out again. Maybe that's winger Patricia LaPierre.
She spilled it forward a little bit, but they're going to play on.
Referee probably being a little forgiving with these conditions.
Mm-hmm. Here comes the counter. Oh, a big collision at the center.
That's number 12, Jackie Titley, CIS All-Star. Ball into contact. And crash ball, number 8, Kara Stuckey, the try scorer.
Good run by Stuckey. Concordia happy to run it up the center.
That's
keep it in the forwards.
Prop Lisa Hoffman at you. This is the kind of attack I think Concordia was looking for. Mm-hmm. Multiple phases with the ball, keeping possession.
Few yards at a time here, Sandy.
Their yards nonetheless. This puts Queens in a tough position, having to defend. They're moving backwards with each phase. Number 10, Erica Hamilton, finds a seam. She could be
going.
Sam Trinier to beat.
She's in. What a great run. Great individual effort. Sorry, that was Hamilton?
Erica Hamilton, Ed.
Nice run.
Very nicely done. She beat one.
So with 7 minutes left in the first half, Concordia now is up 12-3.
Much easier kick now for Titley. She'll be about 15 yards from the center of the field. Queens being met by their coaches in the end zone.
And that's also good.
Well done. Huge advantage over these last 5 minutes to Concordia. 14-3.
Try scored by number 10. SAAC foul the Mamo Dees, Erica Hamilton. Conversion made by number 12, Transformation réussie par numéro 12, Jackie Titley.
Queens is really going to have to pull up their socks in this one, Ed. Suffering two straight scores against just in the last 8 minutes or so.
And both tries converted. That makes a big difference.
And in rugby, Queens will have to kick the ball away instead of receiving it.
Ball's another up. Nice kick.
Oh, very
nice. Taken.
Very nicely taken by Ashley Ward.
See if Queens can put one up before the end of the half. 5 minutes left in the half.
Good rolling drive from Lisa. That's Clara Pegg for Queens. Andrea Wadsworth did a good job to scoop up that loose ball. And that's Jackie Titley into contact for Queens. Ball out. Queens trying to hold up that runner from Concordia. Ball played by Jesse LaPointe.
Oh, nice little fake there by the scrum half. Jesse LaPointe.
Great job trying to keep the Queens defense guessing. Queens having to retreat at each one of these phases. Driving maul.
Concordia likes that driving maul. They do a good job with it.
They do a great job. Great low body position. They're nice and tight together. Very difficult to defend.
4 minutes till the half. 14-3. Concordia, after being behind 3-0, has come back with two converted tries to take the lead.
Yeah, we've seen a huge momentum swing here. That'd be imperative, I think you'd say, for Queens to get some points on the board here before half. Under 4 minutes to play.
It's got to be tough for Queens, Sandy, with that game yesterday, overtime game versus Lethbridge, coming right back out this morning.
24 hours later, you're right, Ed.
The bumps and knocks you take in a regular game, let alone a national championship tournament. That was a physical game yesterday, so I'm sure Queens is a little bit beat up.
It was only one difference in the score sheet in their player roster from yesterday's game versus Lethbridge. And that's winger Claire Miller not in the starting lineup today. I believe we saw her go out with apparently a knee injury.
Oh, that's right.
Danny Maid need to take her spot today. So 14 of the 15, same starters for Queens.
Against the head, Sandy.
Great trailing ball from Concordia. Rock set. And recycled well.
I think Concordia would be smart just to kind of keep it in the forwards and keep possession for the last 2.5 minutes.
That would be a great play from them. But they are penalized. They're going to take a shot at post,
wow.
Referee indicates.
Well, we saw who kicked that convert?
Titley, I believe. Jackie Titley.
If Titley can hit from that far out on that convert, I think she'll have a good chance to put it through. Wouldn't that be a lift for Concordia?
Sure would. That was a penalty against Queens. Referee indicating that she left her feet in the ruck. Those pileups, you've got to stay on your feet.
Look how high Titley places that ball off the turf on her kick.
So are you commenting, Ed, on Titley's tee?
Oh.
That is a bad one.
Here we go. They can take the lead by 14 if she can put this through. And she does it.
Kick is up and good. Fabulous kicker for Concordia.
I think you said it. There's a reason she's a CIS All-Star.
Penalty goal made by Penelite AUC pal Jackie Titley. Time is now being kept by the officials on the field. L'heure est maintenant gardée par les officiels sur le terrain.
So 2 minutes plus a little bit of injury time left in the half. And 17 straight points by Concordia has put them ahead 17-3. And Queens restarts with another beautiful kick.
Queens hard-pressed to stop this Concordia attack. Concordia dominating possession, same way Queens did yesterday.
Yeah, Queens started out strong, but you're right, the tide has turned.
Queens again penalized. Player at the bottom of the ruck. Referee Dustin Ceretti going to have a chat with Captain Jocelyn Poirier about what he's seeing on the field. Penalty certainly hurting Queens, giving Concordia multiple opportunities. That kick by Erica Hamilton finds touch. And we'll have a Concordia lineout.
So we can't look at the scoreboard for time now. It's in the hands of the referee. Pulling down in the lineout, another penalty against Queens. They're having some troubles with that.
Concordia certainly willing to take what Queens is going to give them. And it's at least 6 points with two penalty kicks. Hamilton finds touch again. Queen's going to have to play a little cleaner in those rucks.
Mm-hmm.
Variety of mistakes made in those loose ball situations. Ball up attempt there going to Sarah Nesbitt, the lock. And that could be ball in hand for Queens. Touch flag is up on the far sideline. It looks like Concordia possession.
Well, I think Queens will look forward to getting to the half and regrouping here.
I think so. I think Beth Bars and her team of coaches will have some pointers for the group, because as we talked about earlier, they're playing for their medal lives if they want a factor on Sunday.
The loss here this morning would put them at 0-2, and they would not be competing for a medal.
Two pools of three. After their two pool games, it'll go to best record, but most points. Two first place teams in each pool will play for gold on Sunday. Second place in each pool in the bronze medal game. And with the loss here, Queens would be looking at a fifth place game held Sunday morning. That's not where they want to be.
And there's the half with the score 17-3 for Concordia with 17 unanswered points. They take the lead.
We'll be back with you for the start of the second half. Right, we're back to the start of the second half. Game number one of day two of the CIS National Rugby Championships. Sandy Kay with Ed Holton, broadcasting live on the Sports Streaming Network. 17-3 lead for the Concordia Stingers at halftime. Let's see what Queens can do to regroup. And they're on defense again. Kick lifted by number 10, Erica Hamilton. As Sam Trinier for Queens fields it. And ruck well formed by Queens. Ball taken off the turf by number 10, Annika Rinnis. Both teams happy to trade kicks here early on in the second half. Well tackled by Carly Wong. Concordia still in possession.
Surprising they're coming out kicking.
That is a different tactic than what we saw in the first half. Certainly makes a little bit more sense for Concordia with that early lead.
So what does Queens have to do this half, Sandy?
I think they've done a good job on defense, but they just haven't played with the ball. We saw them with ball in hand first 8 or 9 minutes of the game and put those first 3 points on the board. But then there's just too many mistakes, I think, is the nutshell answer.
Well, we were talking about perhaps they're running out of gas after that tough game with Lethbridge yesterday.
It certainly was a question coming in whether that extra game would, settle them in. Good to have that experience, but maybe right that certainly has taken a little gas out of the tank. Referee having words with both forward packs.
And we found out our referee wasn't, in fact, from Toronto Referee Society. He is from
New Brunswick. Dustin Soretti joining us from the New Brunswick Referee Society.
Great. National flair in the referees as well.
I believe this afternoon's game will feature Quebec referee.
Two Ontario teams this afternoon, Trent and Guelph.
Another tough match coming for the Trent Excalibur. Coming off the heels of a respectable loss, 37-0 at the hands of St. Francis Xavier, our Atlantic Coast representative.
And Trent will be in the same situation as Queens is right now, a must-win.
A loss will put them, if Queens doesn't come out on top in this one, that'll set that fifth-place game on Sunday morning. See that Peterborough's Kayla Root has joined the Queens roster in the second half. I wonder if she'll be taking her spot at flank. Ashley Ward doing what she can to get back to her feet. Referee saying she's knocked that ball forward.
Tough luck for Ward. She just spilt it forward in the tackle. Good run, though. Ashley Ward, CIS All-Canadian this year.
Appears that Kayla Root from Thomas A. Stewart Local High School here is playing blindside flanker, wearing number 6 for Queens in gold. We'll try and bring you any replacements that we see on the Concordia side of the ball. Concordia having a bit of position now that they can make some subs with a 17-point lead. Ball out to winger Patricia LaPierre on this sideline. Ball recycled into the forwards. That's number 6, Leah Leahy.
Some good phases here by Concordia.
Number 3 coming.
Oh,
unfortunate knock on into the hands of Queens. Referee will allow that to play on.
It's a little advantage here for Queens.
And that knock on by Andrea Wadsworth will halt play. Difficult conditions, as we talked about this morning. You can see that snow flying.
Well, good to see Queens come out a little bit on the attack, moving the ball a bit. I think they're going to have to take a few chances and swing the ball wide and take a go at it when you're down by 14. It's 17-3 for Concordia 5 minutes into the second half.
All right, certainly I think we've got to see Justin Poirier become more a bigger part of this offense. She did a great job moving the ball and had an excellent game all around yesterday. We haven't been talking about her as much here so far today.
And we also saw big runs yesterday by the wingers, Pathak and Miller. Now, you mentioned Miller is out, but we haven't seen the ball seem to go wide, both the conditions but also the Concordia defense. So, I guess obvious to say, Queens needs the next score.
Without a doubt, Ed. Down 17-3. We're under 30 minutes to play, so we're about 5 minutes gone in the second half. 14-point margin. Closing that by 3, 5, or 7. That's not going to do it. Knocked forward by number 10, Annika Rinnis.
I'm surprised he didn't just call that a kick. See, through the hands down to her foot.
It certainly could have been taken that way.
I guess if it's wasn't intentional, it has to be called a knock-on.
Queen's going to have to do a better job of keeping hold of that ball. Putting it back into the Concordia hands. We saw what happened in the first half when that was the case.
Yeah, a couple nice tries and some great kicking. Both tries were converted.
Susan Held did a good job to interfere with scrum half Jesse Lapointe's pass. Referee saying Queens was offside.
Mm-hmm.
That'll be ball for Erica Hamilton. That's what I've got her doing. Kick, I don't think is going to find touch. And now it is indicated the ball is out of bounds. This will be an important lineout for Queens. Make sure they take possession of their own ball inside their 22. And well taken by the Gaels. No pass there. Wise to just keep it in hand. Take the tackle. Queens reorganizes. Ball in the hands of Rinnis. And she will find... No, she won't find touch. Taken by number 14, Mandy Aldridge from Concordia.
And she's driven out of bounds. So it'll be Queens line out here.
Pathak did a great job on the wing to get up there in the face of the Concordia winger, not let her get room to run.
Well, Queen's desperate to get some offense going. The clock is down to about 27 minutes left in the game, and Queen's needs some points, preferably a try, preferably a converted try at this point.
Kayla Root up for Queen's. Didn't look like that one was straight.
No. These little things are starting to add up, Sandy. Talked about a lot of little penalties, a lot of things going on in the rucks and mauls. It was costing Queens. And
you're right. The sooner they can get these points on the board, I think the better it's going to be for Queens. Even though there's 26 minutes still showing on the clock, they need to strike quickly.
There's a nice drive off the line out.
Down 17 points to 3. Queens is. And another one of those great stinger driving mauls.
Good tackle.
That's Poirier in on the tackle on Erica Hamilton. That kick will cross the line. Fielded by Sam Trinier. We'll have a 22-meter kick.
I can tell you I'm happy to be in the booth instead of out in the stands, Sam.
This is definitely the number one seat in the house. Looking down, we've got several of our visiting high schools. Girls willing to brave the cold. I suppose a bad day of rugby is better than a good day of school for some of these girls.
I see some of your girls from Adam Scott. I saw Bill Wellwood, North Hastings.
Yesterday we saw teams from Coburg. So they're coming from half an hour or more away.
It's not going to do it. Didn't cross the 22. So we have Concordia scrum. Center of the field at the 22.
Great position. Pressure for the Queen's defense. Keep points off the board. Perhaps it's even more important that they hold off Concordia rather than score themselves. Scrum half, Jesse Lapointe to put the ball in for Concordia.
Good opportunity here for Concordia at the 22-meter line. See what
Ball's
they do.
Ball's one. Great pressure again from Susan Held from Queens. Hamilton finds some room. Rock formed, ball's out. And Maul down that far sideline. Ball squirts out the back. That was number 8, Kara Stuckey. She's got a try today. Forwards calling for support on her hip. And Concordia doing a nice job driving the ball.
Yeah, they'd be wise just to keep it in the forwards here for a bit. A nice drive again there.
Another 5 or 6 meters for the Stingers.
Getting closer. Just a few meters to go.
Queen's going to have to find this ball. Now they're at the goal line. They've got to do a good job to hold it up. We'll wait for the referee's call.
I believe it's held up.
Good job by Queens. Keep those points off the board. That will be Concordia scrum coming at 5 meters. They had the ball moving forward.
Well, Queens certainly knew what was coming each phase, but it was just a matter of whether they could stop it. 5 meter scrum, as you mentioned. So another opportunity for Concordia.
Queen's defense is set. It's great play in the forwards, but certainly the see the Concordia backs as the camera starts to pan out. I think those Stinger backs want the ball. Hands are starting to get a little bit cold.
Also a good shot of all the sponsor banners, the numerous sponsors they have at Trent for the CIS Women's Rugby Championships this year.
BlackBerry, one of our major sponsors, Marchand Sports, PepsiCo, been very generous, and Holiday Inn as well. State Farm Insurance, well represented here in town, just to name a few. We should mention our loyalties to the local rugby club, Peterborough Pagans. You can see a number of members in the audience, both male, female, young and old.
Concordia's gone backwards a bit here. They're backed up almost to the 22. Now they're on the charge.
That's good ball.
Not
referee
knocked
said,
on.
Referee said that went backwards. That was number 8, Huana Law. Pardon me, Huana Gaw. Ball out to Kim Whitty, the outside center. And the referee whistle will come back.
No, Queens, offside.
Queen's offside again. That's not where you want to commit fouls in this game. Not with a team like Concordia.
And you know what they're going to do here, of course. They will shoot for points and try to increase the lead to 20-3. Right now sitting at 17-3 Concordia with 21 minutes left in the game. They'll try to increase that lead. And from what we've seen...
From kicker Jackie Titley, CIS All-Star... and leading point scorer in the Quebec Conference.
She's hit a convert. She's hit a penalty goal and 2 converts. One of the converts almost from the sideline, so no reason to think she'll miss this one.
It's a real difference maker in this game.
And that's right between...
3 more points for Concordia.
20-3 now, Concordia in control of this game. Well, I mentioned coming in, Sandy, that Concordia is undefeated.
They are, and certainly you can see why with their play here in the first half and now 15 minutes into the second half. That penalty try, or pardon me, a penalty, very, very reminiscent of the overtime winner that Queens allowed yesterday in overtime.
It's a nice kick again. Ward almost took that on the go.
Loose ball for Queens. Scooped up at number four, Rochelle Cranenberg. We have a Concordia player down. That's Lisa Hoffman, number 23.
Concordia in possession now.
Queens takes over. Well presented. Oh, Queens has got to do a better job cleaning up those rocks. This near side was not defended. Knock on coming. Referee stops play. Scrum down to Queens University. Job of a trainer difficult there as they were almost run over by both teams attending to the injured Concordia player.
Well, I'm not going to use the word insurmountable, but 17 points with less than 19 minutes to go. Queens has really got to get things going here.
They certainly can do it. Nice take by Ashley Ward. Offloaded to winger Sarah Pathak.
See if Queens can get it wide.
It was a good ball from Susan Held, but Annika Rinna showing her frustration. Queens just not settled into the rhythm of this game here in the second half. Penalties and knock-ons really have been the story so far. Great opportunity nonetheless for Queens, their first appearance at the national championships.
They've done very well in both games.
Certainly gave the defending national champions, three-time national champions, all they could handle yesterday here at Trent's Justin Chiu Stadium. And then it could be shaping up another OUA battle. Queens played Trent earlier in the year. If that is the end result. Referee playing advantage.
Chance for Queens.
Queens with a good run on the outside. I believe that's prop Taylor White from Bancroft, Ontario. Just a couple hours north of here. Well taken by Clara Pegg.
Another scrum to Queens.
Number 17 in for Queens now, we see. Playing prop is Marin McLeod. And I believe that's hooker, number 16, Alana Fleet, for Queens into the game. Not sure how they got that one past us.
Probably not a bad idea to get some fresh legs in. There's a chance for Queens on the penalty.
Susan Held on the take. Keeps it herself to Jocelyn Poirier. Nice. That's good. That's good ball from Queens now. 16, Alana Fleet. Concordia set well on defense. We're not sure of that hands. Carly Wong.
Oh, almost broke through.
That was a nice try. Found a good seam there. Referee's got the knock on. That's good ball movement from Queens.
Mm-hmm.
Perhaps one pass away there from 5 points or more. Concordia now in possession. They've got the ball outside their 22. Referee's hand showing advantage. Offside on Queens again. Another penalty, Ed.
Mm-hmm.
Referee might blow this one now.
He's calling Queens over for a little chat. There's a couple infractions there in a row. And is he showing the yellow card?
Yeah, there may be. That's Peterborough's own, Kayla Root.
Coming in the side of a ruck. We don't know what's been going on down in the field. He may have warned her or warned the team.
There was a discussion with Captain Poirier in the first half. It may have been exactly what was said. Queen's coming in from the side of the ruck. And Kayla Root will put her team down. One player, that'll be 15 on 14 now for 5 minutes, I believe.
And we have less than 15 minutes to go with Concordia well in control, 20-3. I'm very impressed with that drive off the line out.
10 meters gained.
Backing up the defense.
Very difficult to play defense going backwards.
But spilled forward in there somewhere.
The ball came forward somehow. Referee was there to see it. Trainer's out to take a look at a down Concordia player. To 3 in favor of Concordia. He said under 14 minutes to go. Referee has time back in now. Scrum coming to Queen's University.
So as mentioned, Concordia will play Lethbridge tomorrow.
That'll be an excellent matchup.
Mm-hmm.
Lethbridge not looking as I might have imagined a number one seed to look coming into this tournament. That was our first look at them.
Well, there was some talk whether they had fielded their first 15 in that game, their top 15.
And I would be surprised, given that they were down late in that game, that if that was the case, they didn't make a move to get those starters back in. Coach Neil Langevin must have been very, very sure of the 15 women that he had on the field. And they did pull that win out in overtime. Another Concordia driving maul at the Queen's 10-meter line. Good hard tackle by Queens. That was number 3, Clara Pegg.
Went backwards.
Penalty against the Concordia Stingers. That player was not releasing the ball on the ground. Susan Held handing off that ball. Queens will clear their end.
Time running out on Queens. 12 minutes left. Down by 17. The score is 20-3 in favor of Concordia. Time for Queens to take some chances.
Certainly is. We might see a kick here to get them at least to midfield.
Oh, that's what I was thinking. Maybe they should try some kicks downfield and hope for the best.
They've had a tough time squeezing this ball in the second hand. That may be evidence again. Ball not straight, so that's another turnover. Ball to Concordia. Much smaller crowd today than we saw yesterday due to these conditions, but still, loyal rugby fans. You can hear their cheering voices down there. Concordia driving inside 10 meters.
Still driving. Just a few meters to go.
Queens is going to have to join that.
And that's a try. What
beautifully
a
done.
Beautiful forward try. Might even been a couple backs joined in on that push.
Queens was slow to get help in there to hold that up. Once those mauls have momentum, it's tough to stop them.
There's a few Queens players didn't have their heads in and their backs flat, and Lethbridge had a lot of power on that. 25-3 now for Concordia, well in control.
the International Rugby Federation wanted to change up some rules there a couple of years back, and being able to pull down those driving mauls was one of the experimental laws they looked at, not one I'm certainly a fan of, but I'm glad to see that that's been removed. That's such an effective piece of play, and Concordia used it so well.
Convert is good. Score goes to 27-3, Concordia. Less than 10 minutes left.
Try score by number 9. SAVC Pal numéro 9, Jesse Lapointe. Conversion made by number 12. Transformation réussie par numéro 12, Jackie Tedley.
Jesse Lapointe on the try, but a real team try there, Sandy.
It absolutely was. Great play from the forwards. I think Queen's in a position now, under 10 minutes to go. Just trying to get anything going. They'll have ball here in the scrum.
Well, regardless of the score, I've been very impressed with Queen's play, both in the first game and in this game. Like you said, they haven't been able to really get any offense going, but a great first appearance at the CIS Championships.
I'm sure that does a lot for their school, for their program, getting a chance to play on this stage. Substitution coming for Concordia. That's number 23, Lisa Hoffman, out of the game. And we'll get a look at the new player here momentarily.
Well, what's impressive for Queens, too, is that they have 17 first-year players on their declared roster, or the program roster of 35. Half of them are first years. So, you know, we're going to see good things from Queens in the future.
I do believe you're right, Ed. That won't be the last time that we see them here at the CIS Championships. Success breeds success. Well defended by Queens on the edge of the ruck. Concordia still in possession. Nicely offloaded.
Good tackle there.
Great tackle by Jocelyn Poirier. Textbook tackling from the Queens open side flanker.
Poirier's everywhere on the field.
Taken by number 4, Claire Hortop. Product of Mississauga, Ontario.
There's a big kick down the side.
And that's going to stay in touch. Pressure for Sam Trinier to field that.
Trouble.
We're seeing.
And now Queens will clear. Maybe a quick line out here? Yes? No.
Referee saying that ball was touched out of bounds. Referee Dustin Cerruti having a word with his touch judge.
I didn't think that ball was touched. I may have missed it.
That is the option for these players to, if the ball wasn't touched by someone out of bounds, to put that ball back in the field of play. As long as the ball goes in over that first hash line at 5 meters, and as long as it's straight or backwards.
And we have Dan Froggett from the Peterborough Rugby Club and his, I believe it's under 18
under
girls
18 team, I think you're right, Ed.
Are the ball girls for the games.
Beautifully taken in the line out by the Stingers. And what do you know, another driving maul.
They certainly have that down pat.
Certainly the only way you can stop that really is to get it, hit it before it starts moving. Referee has time out on the field.
Oh!
And a sin bin to Jocelyn Poirier.
Did you see what happened there?
I didn't see it, Ed. She said she's leaving her feet in the ruck.
Not going for points this time. Be content just to find touch and take a 5-meter line out.
Well, Kayla Root's back in the game, having served her 5 minutes in bin, and then there goes what you could arguably say is the heart of the Queen's defense. And that will finish off the game for her with only 5 minutes remaining.
Well, having Root off certainly hurt, and now Poye, they're going to be hard-pressed. Nice take in the line out. And, of course, the drive is on.